Dinosaurs ruled the Earth for over 100 million years and then disappeared seemingly overnight. It was an earth-shattering event that was close to extinguishing life forever. But how did so many other species survive? This is a moment-by-moment account of one of the darkest events this planet has ever experienced. The last day of the dinosaurs. Hi, I'm Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Paleologic. We don't know what time or day it was. Probably a Monday. 66 million years ago, some of the most famous dinos were slowly starting their week. T-Rex, Triceratops, and Ankylosaurus were looking for their next meal. Pachycephalosauruses were headbutting each other, and over in the ocean, mosasaurs were terrorizing fish. It was business as usual. But there was a light in the sky that had been getting bigger, and that particular morning, it seemed much bigger than usual. It was no star. It was a giant asteroid, estimated to be between 15 and 80 kilometers wide. It was flying at speeds of over 30 kilometers a second and on a collision course with planet Earth. Its name was Chicxulub. If the same thing happened to us, we'd have only a few weeks between the time that we could see it by the naked eye and when it hit the ground. Suddenly, it hit the atmosphere, making it burn brighter than ever before. A few seconds later, it touched down. The asteroid crashed into a shallow sea in the modern-day Yucatan Peninsula in the Gulf of Mexico. The impact had the power of about 10 billion nuclear bombs, and everything within about 1,000 kilometers was instantly vaporized. In the rest of North America, the effects took a few seconds. First, a massive shockwave traveling at 1,000 kilometers an hour blew away trees and dinos. Then, the Earth began to tremble. Magnitude 11 earthquakes shot dinos up into the air like a trampoline. A record number of T-Rex bones were broken simultaneously. The impact kicked up dirt into the atmosphere, which melted and rained down as burning glass and flying lava. The dinos beneath were pelted for close to an hour. The fireballs heated up the atmosphere to hundreds of degrees for a few minutes. The planet was a massive convection oven that cooked the dinosaurs evenly. The world was aflame as forest fires ravaged jungles and Cretaceous polar forests. Only those animals who could hide in burrows, caves, or underwater were able to survive. At the same time, earthquakes, tsunamis, and tornadoes devastated the land. The dust and soot lingered in the air for years, blocking out the sun and killing most of the surviving plants. The food chain was officially broken down. No terrestrial animal over 20 kilos survived this event. All non-avian dinos waved goodbye. In the ocean, the dark skies caused plankton to die, starting a chain reaction that would cause most large marine species to starve to extinction. Worldwide, only about a quarter of all species would survive. Some aquatic animals did survive the carnage going on at the surface. Sharks, turtles, and crocs were some of the ancient animals that survived. Small avian dinosaurs and tiny mammals also survived by hiding in burrows and caves. Those tiny mammals would eventually grow to rule the Earth. They were our direct ancestors. This was one of the most important days in the history of the world. And we know how it happened, thanks to paleontology. Let's start with the asteroid impact. We knew something dramatic happened at the end of the Cretaceous, because dinosaurs abruptly stopped showing up in the fossil record around 66 million years ago. Luis and Walter Alvarez, a cute father and son duo of physicists, observed that if you look at rocks from the end of the Cretaceous, eventually you find a band of clay with iridium concentrations 100% higher than normal. Iridium is very rare on Earth, but relatively common on asteroids. The rocks below the iridium-rich band of clay were chock-full of fossils, but the ones above it showed barely any sign of having supported life. The evidence for an asteroid impact was there. And about a decade later, the crater was found in Mexico. It's not easy to realize you're in a crater, since it's 180 kilometers wide. Studies found abnormal quartz formations and tektites, the remains of the molten glass that pelted the dinosaurs, confirming the occurrence of the catastrophic event. It's possible that by the time the asteroid collided with Earth, other factors were already hitting dinosaurs pretty hard. There's evidence of climate change and elevated volcano activity in the Cretaceous, but the asteroid was the coup de grâce. But the few terrestrial survivors persevered and eventually radiated into all the wonderful species we have today. And if you're feeling a bit down, remember this. Your ancestors survived a massive asteroid impact and a catastrophic extinction event. You got this. So what should we talk about next? Please let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for watching. See ya! We've got big news! Animalogic has just launched a brand new channel membership program. It's the easiest way to support the channel and helps us keep bringing you original wildlife content.
With the staff from Scales Nature Park, with a few of the newly hatched baby turtles, today we're here to release some of those turtles back to freedom.
I never thought, Danielle, that you'd be interacting with this wolverine's behavior. This is amazing.
If you become an Animalogic superfan, you'll get priority replies to your comments, photos, and status updates when we're in the field, discounted merch from our store, art from the show, as well as Animalogic exclusive emojis and loyalty badges. There's also a few exciting new perks in the works, so if you like the channel and want to support us and become a part of Animalogic, please become a member by clicking on the join button below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the episode.